So, dear Telok, how are you doing and how has it been to fight against the virus? We've read the news.
No, it's I don't know. It sucks, of course. There's not much to do besides just sit and wait to see if they can make a vaccine. So, of course, everything is cancelled over here for the rest of the year. No shows at all. Yes, we don't even talk to each other. We just have the time off each other and not talk to anyone. The same as Italy, I guess. Nothing is going on.
So, what can you tell us about Miami Murder, the debut album by your new project, Bergeton?
Well, this is something that I recorded in 2018. It sprung out from boredom, I guess. I was waiting for something to do just before I started on the next Mayhem album.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was just sitting around playing on my computer, and suddenly I had like 10 songs or something. So I just figured I released it. It's electronic music is not something new for me. Something that I used to do back in the year 2000, I guess. 2000 to 2005, I made tons of electronic music. But I didn't release any of it, just sitting on my computer.
Yeah, and I've seen there is a beautiful pink vinyl available. What do you think about such format in nowadays musical scene in the digital era?
Well, to me, it's releasing a vinyl is like the ultimate thing for me. It has always been releasing vinyls. That's the most important thing for me. Even though the digital thing is very important these days, I always want to release a vinyl.
Yeah, I mean, it's something that, you know, the fans could appreciate. I've seen you released also t-shirts and merchandise.
I know. I already had all of that set up, so it's very easy for me to sell merch because I already have my merch store. So it's not a problem for me to just put it up there if people want it, you know. So it's smart to just have it in case anyone wants it.
Will there be the possibility, once the sanitary emergency will be over, to see Bergeton also on stage with a live set?
I've been talking with some friends about it, and could be, actually. Right now, I don't know. We haven't manifested any plans or anything. We just talk about it and talk what we really want to do with the show and something like that. And also, we need more songs. And that's not a problem because I got tons of more of those songs. So we'll see, I guess. First thing first, the first thing now is to get Mayhem back up. That hopefully starts next year. We will see.
Which are your main inspirations when you compose electronic music?
For this album, I don't know. I think I just had a synthwave period, I think.
Yeah.
I just recently discovered synthwave before making these songs, and I was very inspired by synthwave genre in whole, you know. There's many bands like Carpet the Brute and stuff like that.
Do you think you might be doing like soundtrack music one day, thinking about Bergeton?
I don't know. Already did some writing music for a play here in Norway, so that was a cool challenge. And I like to do like musical challenges. I think that's very interesting. So if the possibility come up one day, that would be awesome to do, actually.
Talking about Demon from Mayhem, what can you tell us about its genesis and the actual recording and production of the album? What do you recall?
No, actually, it took a long time to write the songs because we couldn't agree on what direction we wanted to go. So we tried out many types of songs for a long time. I think maybe we have like almost 2 hours leftover music from that album. So the writing process was a very long, lengthy one. And also we recorded the whole thing in Sweden, or not the whole thing, but some of it. We recorded the vocals and drums in Sweden. And I recorded my guitars here in Oslo, and also Jørn's Necrobutcher's bass here. Mm-hmm. And Charles did his guitars in Netherlands. So it was like a joint effort in many countries that came together.
And what do you recall about composing and recording Esoteric Warfare, how was for you to be a part of a legendary band with such a prominent role, since you composed and produced the album?
It was a cool challenge, actually. I'm very hardworking when I first start to work, so the writing and composing wasn't any problem. But the problem was to have ideas that the band agreed on. I couldn't just go in there and tell the band this is how it should be, because I had to listen to what they wanted to have, you know, since being the new guy and everything. But I think we landed on something unique, as usual, with Mayhem. It doesn't sound like anything else they released, and that's a cool thing. Even though I can write tons of music, this one was probably the hardest album I've ever written, I think, because of the history and all that. And I also had to incorporate my style into both Euronymous and Blasphemous music in a way. So it was a challenge, but I think it turned out okay.
It's been 3 years since the latest release. Do you have any updates and news for the fans of Nidingr?
Not really. We did have a plan right before the corona thing hit, I think it was. And we started to write stuff, but it just disappeared, I think. We just stopped working on it for some reason. I don't know.
Okay.
But right now we are without any labels and everything, so I don't know what to do. I'm not sure if we even should release a new album. Maybe that's it for us. I don't know.
So you aren't composing new stuff?
No, not at the moment. We will see how that goes. Right now I'm not inspired to write anything for needing it. So we will see in the future.
And you have a very successful YouTube channel. How do you see nowadays technology when used for communication, also with fans in the music area? It's very direct.
Yeah, for me, I think it's I never thought about the possibility to actually do that YouTube stuff as a communication channel for the fans. But it worked out very cool, I think. And it's a very direct way of communicating with the fans and also be creative. So for me, that's what I'm doing these days, doing my YouTube channel.
Yeah, and what kind of music do you like to listen to in your spare time, also outside of metal?
Actually, I don't listen to music when I have a spare time.
No?
No. Maybe if I drink, but then I listen to all kinds of music. Nothing special, you know. I listen to any genre as long as it's good music.
What do you think about the Norwegian musical scene nowadays, in every kind of music, I mean?
It's hard for me to say because I don't really follow any scene at all. I just do my own stuff.
Okay.
I'm very single-minded. Oof.
So, do you have any plans right now, at the moment, I mean, that you can tell us?
I was planning on releasing or recording a video today for my YouTube channel, but somehow I could never get out the door, so I'm still on the couch.
Okay.
So I'm thinking about getting back to that tomorrow again and record a video and release it on Sunday.
So do you have like one final message and greeting to the Italian fans of Telok?
Yeah, it would be cool if you can check out my new project Bergeton and also check out my YouTube channel. That's where I'm very active these days. So if you want to follow my life, I guess that's the channel to tune into these days.